Squad video. It's Lauren,
Brooke,
Kirsten.
Kirsten. And so we're doing a story time video. There is a rock in my butt.
I got it.
You got it. It's right there. Okay, that works. Okay, so this is a story time video. It's about when somebody broke into our house and it was just me and Kirsten. But Brooke was also somewhat involved, so she's gonna be in it too, so. Okay, so I was on the bus and like Kirsten,
we were.
You weren't there.
Yeah, I was also. Oh yeah, never mind.
Kirsten was really feeling like really nauseous that morning and didn't go to school. And so she wasn't at school, and so she wasn't on the bus. So it was just me on the bus. I got off the bus and I texted Kirsten. I was like, hey, you wanna come over after school so I'm not alone? She's like, yeah, sure. Oh no, you texted me. You're like, hey, I'm gonna come over once you get off the bus, okay? So text me when you get home.
Yeah.
And so.
You weren't even home here for 5 minutes before I got here.
I was here for like about 5 minutes, for a good 5 minutes. Sorry, my kitty's over there. And so I texted her and then I got off the bus because I was like, hey, I'm about to be at my house. And so got off the bus and my side, like my gate, like around my house here, I don't know, but there's like one right there and there's one on the other side and the one over there was wide open. And I was like, that's not normal, but my brother hadn't, oh, there's a bunch of ants. My brother hadn't gone to college yet because he was about to go to school. And I was like, okay, it could have just been him or something. He could have. And so I didn't know, I just blew it off. Like it was nothing, so. About a good five minutes later, Kirsten showed up, you know, TV off, because we don't watch TV after school. We never did, never have. All we do is like listen to music and chill. And it was a good Friday afternoon, going great. My day was fine, honestly. Like I didn't even have a bad Friday. Pretty good Friday. You know, we're sitting there on our phones. We're looking at pictures of hairstyles and hair dyeing and all that stuff for her because of course, like, you know, she was dying her hair and stuff. And so we're sitting there. And
it was about 20 minutes we were sitting there just chilling.
15, 20 minutes, good amount of time, honestly. And like, they get home like 30 minutes after us. So, because they're obviously on the other bus, little kid bus, it's just what I call it. You're almost on the big kid bus, almost. And so, oh, that's a white creepy van, that's creepy.
And we're talking about a creepy story.
Yes, I know, that's great. And I kind of had to film, like, we're filming this outside. I don't want to, but we did. But
we were sitting on, like, the side of the couch where you couldn't see the back door.
We were sitting on one cushion together. We were, like, cuddled up, like we always do. We're always sitting on one cushion together. And, like, you couldn't see the back door from that cushion.
And the back door couldn't see you.
Yeah. Yeah, so like you couldn't see the back door couldn't see you.
But you could see the back door through the window.
Barely.
Barely.
And so we heard bang, 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 bang.
And then the doorknob like.
And the doorknob was like jiggling. And we were like, me and Kirsten immediately froze. And so like a few seconds later, Kirsten, I think I saw it vaguely. Like we have like these lace curtains over the kitchen windows, and I vaguely saw them. Kirsten kind of saw them walk around the house, and Kirsten stood up after she saw that, and she stood up and we jolted to the other side of the house because we knew he was
jolted.
Jolted, yes.
Bolted?
Jolted. No, we jolted.
I don't know what that means.
Jolted. It's like ran really fast. Like we jolted. Oh, Kirsten. No, it's jolted.
Okay.
So we jolted to the other side of that, like, house, basically. The other side of the living room. And
went to the hallway.
Well, first we did run to the hallway, and then we kind of came out, waiting for some noise at the front door, basically. And so we heard the doorbell ring a bunch, heard some knocking on the front door, and so I was like, Kirsten, see who it is. Just see who it is. Obviously, they want to see who's home or something. I didn't know. Like, we didn't know our house was getting broken into. We had no clue what was going on. Never, nothing like this has ever happened. And we stay home all the time, or we did. home alone all the time. And so both of my parents at the time were working both up like in a big city, like
Atlanta,
basically. We live in Georgia. So they were an hour away, and plus traffic if there was any. My mom was working in Thomaston, which was like 30 minutes away. My dad was an hour or plus, like, because traffic could have been bad.
And the neighbors weren't home.
Oh, first person I called was my, okay, well, actually, no, I'm not there yet. And so when, like, we heard the doors and stuff, I was like, here, so I can see who it is. Just jump out and see who it is. And so we finally both jumped out. Well, she jumped out, and then there was nothing there. And that's Brooke's mom. And she was like, I don't see nothing. And I was like, okay. And so I walked over there, and there was nothing there. And we'll be right back.
Yeah.